Hello everyone, welcome to Task IAS. This is our second class under Unit 6 Anthropological Theories. In last class, we have discussed classical evolutionist and Tyler, Morgan, Fraser. These three thinkers have been discussed in detail. Today we will discuss about historical particularism and about Franz Boas. So today's theory is smaller in size as compared to earlier one, and here we have to discuss about only one thinker. One important thing is that if you have liked our lecture, then please like, share and subscribe Task IAS. That will give us motivation to continue this series. So let's start today's class. Historical particularism. So what we mean by historical particularism? Now we start decoding this term. Historical means related to history, and particularism means focus on particular things. So in historical particularism, we can simply define that we focus on every aspect of any society or culture, and we study its history in detail to understand what's its present and what can be its future. So we are understanding his past so that we will have better understanding of his present and future, and every society or culture is studied in detail. That's why word particularism. Now this approach was emerged in 20th century, and we have discussed in our earlier class that classical evolutionists were famous around 19th century, although Fraser comes in 20th century, but Tyler and Morgan has done their work in 19th century. This came in 20th century, so this was a successor of classical evolutionist, and this theory emerged against criticism of classical evolutionist, because in classical evolutionist they focus on generalizing things, because according to them evolution is linear and every society will go through three stages, that is savagery, barbarism and civilization. So they have ethnocentric approach. They have decided that Western societies are more developed, they are more superior, and other societies are inferior to them. So this approach was criticized by Boas, and he has developed his theory against criticism of classical evolutionist. So we have understood what we mean by historical particularism from its word meaning by decoding these terms. Secondly, we have understood that this theory emerged because of criticism of classical evolutionist. Now, core concept of this theory is that every society or every culture has its own past, because of which it has its present form, as well as it has its unique cultural environment. It has external forces, and these external forces are unique for every society. So its past as well as its present environment, these features has role in deciding what this society or culture is in present times. If these are unique, then how we can see that every culture or society will have one order of evolution? How any thinker can ignore these variations, these past variations as well as these present external factors? Boas focused on these factors, and according to him, we should focus on understanding past as well as understanding these present external factors to understand these societies. So this was his approach. Now second characteristic is that he has focused on fieldwork as well as ethnography, whereas earlier classical evolutionists focus on ethnology. In ethnology they are focusing on comparison, and in ethnography we are studying every culture or society in detail. That's why Boas was against this comparison method, because according to him, if you are comparing one and two, then of course you have biasness towards any one of them, and you can't judge remaining society or culture with objectivity, and this is hindrance in study of that particular society. So he has focused on field work as well as ethnography. Even he has given some guidelines for later anthropologists that they should focus on field work, they should spend long time in field, and they should also learn local language so that they can collect accurate data. So this was his contribution in our discipline. Now we will study about contribution. So till now we have discussed some basic idea about this theory, his model that every present society formed because of his past as well as its present external factors. He has criticized classical evolutionist. He has focused on ethnographic or field work. Now, contribution of historical particularism, this particular theory has contributed. This has succeeded in eliminating racism from anthropology because earlier classical evolutionist has idea of Western superiority because only whites can have a civilizational level society and only these societies have moral values, these are happy society and others are immoral as well as unhappy society. But this superiority was eliminated by Boas. His another contribution was concept of cultural relativism. According to this concept, we should study every culture from its own objectives, from its own surroundings. How you can judge any culture without understanding its past as well as without understanding its own outer external factors. So we should judge this culture from its environment only. Thus there is no need of any reference culture or society. So he has countered this concept and give his concept of cultural relativism against concept of ethnocentrism that was promoted by cultural evolutionist. Now, historical particularism has focused on field work. We have discussed point this earlier also, because if you want to study any particular culture in detail, you have to go for long field work studies. But there were limitations of this approach also. For example, Malinowski, he has criticized that if we focus only on data collection and not giving any theory, then this will be difficult for any new researcher. How will they understand so much large data without any model or without any theory? Thus, this will be not possible for that new researcher to continue his work on this particular study. So this was limitation of this approach. Now we will discuss about Franz Boas individually. So he was a multi-talented personality. Earlier he was a student of physics and geography, and you can analyze his interest by his dissertation work. He has done work on contribution to the understanding of color of water. So he has that logical or curious mind. He focused on more on observation, and these observational skills has promoted him to develop interest in observing primitive societies or simple societies. That's why his interest developed in field work. So this background helped him to develop interest in field work. He was native to Germany, but when he was doing some work on physics, he has traveled to Canada and observed Eskimos of Baffin Island. Then he developed interest in studying their particular culture, their customs, traditions, and he then gave anthropological monograph, and this monograph was Central Eskimo. Now, after that he has joined teaching in Europe. Later he come back to America and he again did fieldwork study on Kwakitul. After that he has developed interest in American local societies as well. That's why he has also acquired American citizenship. So till now we can say that he has done work because of his interest, and due to that interest he has done fieldwork studies among Eskimos and later on Kwakitul. He has done his studies, but he didn't give any theory Even this theory of historical particularism, this theory was not given by him. It was later anthropologists that they have defined him in a particular theory, and they have given name that is, this is historical particularism, because he was against any model or theory. Because according to him, any theory or any model can't define variations, and human has so much variations in physical as well as his social dimension. So this historical approach, although he has given this approach, but he has never defined that I have this particular theory in my mind. This idea that every culture developed independently, so other dimensions like geography, climate, resources of that particular area, all these factors influence in development of that society. So that's why he has not in favor of given any theory. So because of these arguments, he has also favored in-depth investigation of any society or any community before giving any data about them. So all this was about historical particularism as well as about Franz Boas. So you have analyzed that Franz Boas and his theory was not used. It was simpler because there is no theory at all. It was later anthropologists that has given this name. Thus, it was easy to understand. But how you can continue his work later, that was problematic. So we have understood his contribution and his positive of his theory, that it was very simple and it has given importance to variation. We have also understood limitations, that there is no theory buildup, so it was very difficult for later anthropologists to continue his theory. Now, these were some of the direct points related to his theory and him, but indirectly he has played important role in our discipline, because firstly he has focused on fieldwork study that inspired Malinowski to develop participant observation as one of the method in fieldwork studies. That is the central idea of our discipline. Secondly, he has inspired many young people to pursue anthropology and do fieldwork. And some of them are Kroeber, Mead, Benedict, Whistler. So they have developed an American school later. Thus, we can say Boas has role in establishing American anthropology. Thus, he has important role in our discipline. So that's all for today. We have covered second theory also, historical particularism. So every day we will try to cover one theory, so that at the end of the 10 or 12 days, you will complete this unit. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.